With the elections over in the UK once more, and my faith in humanity lower than the ocean floor, I think it's high time that I complain about a game that I f***ing hate. It was recently brought to my attention that I once talked about one of the worst games I'd ever experienced, but that I never actually finished my rant about it. I said, and I quote, "Damn, I could go on about this all day, but I think I'll leave the rest of my rant for another time." Well, I guess that day's finally arrived, much to my dismay. But unlike the politicians of the United Kingdom, I intend to make good on my promises. Sorry for being all political and cynical and shit, but I'm not actually sorry. Limbo of the Lost is hands down my joint number one worst game ever made, holding the title with only Rayplay. This is a game that everyone who is thinking of getting into game design or even game journalism should play at least once and try to go all the way through it. This is a game that doesn't understand how to engage its target audience. In fact, I'm almost convinced that the target audience was the developers themselves. So in that case, this game wasn't made for you, so stop playing it. It's absolutely incredible how much this game got wrong. In fact, it's easy to say what this game got right rather than what it got wrong. It controls well enough and it's not bugged or anything, at least I never found any. But that's about as far as it goes. For the purpose of this rant, I'm not going to recover what I've already covered before, so instead, I'll just put a link at the bottom of the screen, there you go, which will direct you to that last video, and you can catch up on all of the creamy goodness from before. Meaning that this rant will only cover what I didn't talk about before. So in a way, this is a long overdue second half. First things first, the story. Makes about as much sense as trying to deep fry your balls. Actually, trying to deep fry one's own balls is quite a coherent plot, if not a little masochistic, but it's pretty self-explanatory. Man puts balls in deep fat fryer. Why? To see what it feels like. There, a plot we can all grasp. Coming soon to a cinema near you. But Limbo's plot is just a collection of random events duct taped together and passed off as a plot. Look, you start off in Limbo, no f***ing clue how you got there. You meet up with an upside down dude who tells you something that's quite hard to hear because the sound is f***ed. Then you spend two chapters, that's a third of the game by the way, wandering around to try and get to the next place because what else is there to do? Then after that the game turns into Scooby-Doo by getting you to solve a completely unrelated mystery that contributes nothing to the already non-existent plot. Then after that I believe I lost the will to live, and then you get to the end. Thinking back on it now, I can't believe I didn't mention the ending the last time I talked about this game. Sure, I talked about the end cutscene, which is one of the most epic end cutscenes ever, and if you haven't seen it, then holy shit are you in for a real scorcher. But I never mentioned the final puzzle. Right, check this out. Throughout the game, you have access to an interactive menu that will let you do things like pick up an item, or use said item, save game, etc. But you'll notice a Ouija board in the centre of this menu. At no point during the rest of the game does this board ever get used or even mentioned by the game, and so you're not going to take any notice of it because, well, if it's not getting used, then why would you? That is, right up until the very end when it becomes absolutely vital to complete a timed puzzle. It's like the finishing touches on a three-story decorated turd that is this game. How would anyone know to use this completely unrelated mechanic that is never mentioned, used, or brought up ever throughout the entire game, and then instantly know to use it in a very specific way by spelling out a certain word in the right place? Point-and-click games are notorious for stupid and nonsensical puzzle solutions, but this one's just crap! It's like the devs put it in the system right at the start of the game, and then realised that they'd forgot to use it, and so decided to put it in a puzzle right at the very end. Sorry to go back to it, but I want to carry on talking about the pacing of the plot. Imagine for a moment that a small child has come up with what he thinks is a fantastic story, filled with interesting characters, engaging and fun-filled twists and turns, and that it's going to be an instant success, even though no one has the heart to tell that kid that what he's got is shit. Now imagine that, convinced that this story is going to be a smash hit, this kid goes on to make other stories surrounding the original plot, thus creating a series that is substandard in comparison to the original story, which itself was shit. Now take that idea, and now imagine that this kid got so excited about this series that he decided to merge the entire thing into one story, but changed nothing about its pacing. That is as close as I can describe how this game's plot feels like. It feels like the developers fell in love with something that was a complete mess to begin with, started coming up with loads of different ideas as to what the main character should do, but decided to inject all of those ideas, even if it meant the connectivity between one set of events and another was completely f***ed. One moment you're trying to escape from limbo, and then the next you're trying to solve a mystery surrounding the disappearance of a non-consequential character. Why? Because the developers thought it'd be cool because that's the situation they wanted to see Briggs in. That's the main character, by the way. None of it makes sense, and as a result, the player becomes isolated from the story. But f*** the player. The devs liked the game, and if the devs liked the game, then you will too, right? Right, now, if this video was a Phoenix Wright case, the prosecution would be demanding that I show evidence right about now. So here's some evidence. Go to Amazon and search for Limbo of the Lost. Now go to the reviews and look for the only 5-star review that's actually serious. This review was actually made by one of the main developers, posing as a normal gamer. In it he claims how much he liked the demo and how all the characters were awesome, blah blah blah. But then he goes on to say that he's looking forward to a sequel. A sequel. That's right. He's only played the demo and is hoping that the devs make a sequel. Not that he's played the demo and is looking forward to the finished article, which is what someone who wasn't a part of the game's developments would say. No, he skipped that and moved on to Limbo 2. I've only played the first chapter of Limbo 1, but f*** the rest of that game, I want to dive straight into the second one. What's more is that this review was featured on the game's box art as a positive review to show the consumer that other people like this game too. Surely if the game was good enough, then the developers wouldn't need to quote themselves saying how much they liked it. That should set off some alarm bells before you even open the box. All the characters are weird and have no real reason to be there. Maybe that's the nature of Limbo itself, but a bit of character establishment would be nice. Otherwise you're letting the player make up their own minds about each character, rather than how the developers want each character to be established. Okay, take Nilmates for example. The rest of the characters find him a bit annoying, but a comical and likeable character. But that alone isn't enough to make us like him. The first time you meet him, he's portrayed as an annoying little shit that needs to shut up, and even Briggs starts falling asleep during their first conversation. But despite all of the other characters changing their opinions on him, his personality never actually changes, meaning that our first impression of him remains the same throughout the game. He's an annoying little shit that needs to shut up when you first meet him, and he's still an annoying little shit that seriously needs to shut up by the end. The only difference in character with this particular figure is that by the end, he's been burnt. That's not character development! That's just giving him third-degree burns! And he still doesn't shut up. Right. With that aside, are you ready now for a round of Spot the Stolen Intellectual Property? Also known as Find the Plagiarism? As mentioned in my last video, this game has ripped off quite a lot of assets from other games, including, but not limited to, Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind, Elder Scrolls 4 Oblivion, and Thief Deadly Shadows. I found some more when I came to do this video as well. Are you ready? The background music during the swamp stage is actually from the main menu in Unreal 2 The Awakening. Many, many images and backdrops are taken from various painkiller levels. I believe I read somewhere that certain images from the intro cutscene were taken from Diablo 2. The parts where Briggs does an Indiana Jones reference, and you get a small song extract from the Indiana Jones theme tune, was actually taken from Serious Sam. Several backdrops were taken from two of the Pirates of the Caribbean films. The idea of having a character that crawls along the ceiling was also ripped from Painkiller, as several enemies in the Battle Out of Hell expansion includes them. And I think I'm spent. I believe there are also some images taken from World of Warcraft, but since I've never played that game, then I think I'll pass on that one. Also, what is the whole purpose of the plot? It gets explained at the start that Briggs is in limbo, so his ultimate goal is to escape, but by the end of it, he doesn't escape and ends up getting crowned King of Limbo. For someone who's trying to escape a particular place, I can't think of a bigger fail than getting put in charge of it, which ultimately renders everything that you were trying to do throughout the entire game completely pointless. Maybe it was because he fell in love with all the characters and decided to stay there, but when did he start caring for each character? I was there the entire time and I don't remember such a thing happening. All I remember was going from place to place with no goal or reason to be there and seeing how far I could push a screwdriver into my ear without doing too much brain damage. Bacon, bacon, bacon. I spanned the shit out of the walkthrough in this game, and with no shame whatsoever, because I thought, why should I even try to make sense of this game when it expects me to solve a puzzle where you've got to get alcohol for someone by combining a jug of water with a worm to make tequila? I know I mentioned this the last time, but are you kidding me? Water and a worm? The f**k? And I love the fact that this game was hinting that there was going to be a sequel right at the end, where the two dudes with no connection to the plot go, how about best out of three, brother? Very well, brother. This game was removed from store shelves 3 months after release, and as a result of plagiarism and such, this game fell into obscurity before anyone had even heard about it. Had its own complete inability to create original content not unwittingly saved it from a universal bashing, then this game would have quickly become notorious for being one of the worst games of all time. Instead, it gets the honour of joining the game's protagonist of wandering around the plains of Limbo with absolutely f*** all to do for the rest of time, and watch the world forget that at one point, this was actually a game. And that's this one done. I never want to come back to this game now, okay? I've exhausted everything I wanted to say. Now you better leave quickly before I start going on about the election again. Life is killing me. I swear sometimes I think this life is killing me. Sometimes I think this life is killing me.